This is an introduction to Microsoft Excel version 2010, part 3 of 3. In this part, I will be going over the ribbon at the top of the screen, as well as the specific tabs that are associated with it. Each of these tabs contain different options available to the user to interact with the spreadsheet. I'll be starting with the Home tab. The Home tab is generally the first one selected when you open up a spreadsheet. As you can see, there are a large number of options available here, most of which are used to format the cells themselves. Formatting of a cell I will go into more detail in a separate video. This is just a brief introduction. The first section of the Home tab is the Clipboard. With the Clipboard, you can cut, copy, and paste data from one location to another. The second section is Font. With this section, you can change the characteristics of the font in a selected cell or a selected range of cells. You can change the font face, size, whether it's bold, italics, underlined, as well as its color. The next section is alignment. Each cell has its own specific alignment default. For example, when text is entered, the default alignment is on the left side of the cell and the bottom of the cell. When the text takes up the full height of the cell, the vertical alignment is disregarded. However, if I change the height, you can see that the text remains at the bottom of the cell. Numbers, on the other hand, have a default alignment of right. This allows them to line up on the right side of a cell in a nice line. The next section is number. In this section, you can change the number type of a selected cell. By default, this is general. However, you can also change it to number, currency, time, date, and text. When it's selected as general, there is no specific format, so it automatically chooses what formatting to use. The next section is styles. These are pre-made styles you can apply to a selected range of cells. For example, if I select the data, set 1, and go to Format as Table, I can choose from one of these pre-made table formats, and it will be automatically applied to the cell. The next section is cells. Here you can insert, delete, or format cells or selected ranges of cells. For example, if I delete one cell, the data will move up to replace it. The next section is editing. This is to edit a range of data that has been selected. You can sort it from largest to smallest, or smallest to largest, as well as create a series of data. The next tab is insert. On the Insert tab, you can see that there are different types of things you can insert. For example, you can insert a table within the spreadsheet. You can insert illustrations such as pictures, clip arts that are installed with the Microsoft Excel, and different shapes. You can also insert charts and graphs, and they have a large range of selected options that you could use. Some of the other things you can enter are sparklines, filters, hyperlinks, and text. Since you are able to enter directly into the cells, the only reason you would use a text box is if you wanted the data to be separate from the constraints of the cell. You can also enter symbols and equations that are pre-made. The next tab is page layout. This you will almost always use when you're printing. For example, you can give specific themes to your printed page. You can change the page setup, and some of these options are also available on the Print tab. You can change the scaling to make the data fit within a certain range. The sheet options, for example, you can tell it to print the grid lines that are already available on it, but the default is to leave those off. And you can arrange different spreadsheets within your screen. This option does not affect printing at all. The next tab is formulas. This is extremely useful when you're looking for a type of function and you're not sure which one it is. Here, you can look it up from these tabs, functions you have recently used, and functions that are associated with a specific type of calculation. The next section is defined names. For example, Name Manager allows you to edit the names of cells on the spreadsheet. In a previous video, I named a cell FAHR. If I wish, I can delete this and I go back, and that cell no longer has the name of FAHR. It has reverted back to its original name, which is its location of B4. I can also create a name from selection. So if I select these two cells, click Create from Selection, and I can tell it to create names from the left column to the right. And now if I click on this cell, it has the name of Celsius, which is its label in the left column. The next section is formula auditing, which allows you to track the referencing in your cells. That, however, we will go over when we get to cell referencing itself. The next section is calculation options. In calculation options, you can choose when to calculate the data on a spreadsheet. By default, the spreadsheet will automatically recalculate every time something changes. The next tab is data. On the data tab, you can import data from a different source. You can sort and filter data as you were able to from the home tab. And you can perform analyses on the data from these different options here. Additional data tools that appear on this tab are solver and regression. These we'll go over in a different video, along with how to add them to the data tab. The next tab is review. The review tab allows you to review the data within the spreadsheet. You can check the spelling, you can research, and you can use the thesaurus. It also gives you the option of translating from languages and adding comments. Here, you can protect the workbook with a password or track the changes you make as you go. This is useful when it's a shared workbook and you want to make sure you don't change something you shouldn't. The next tab is View. In the View tab, you change the way you look at the spreadsheet. For example, default is a normal layout. You can also switch to page layout, which shows you what the data would look like when printed. These options are also available at the bottom of the screen here. You can also zoom by selecting here and changing the zoom level, and zoom is also available at the bottom of the screen as well. Window allows you to arrange different open workbooks on your screen so you can view more than one at a time. The Developer tab is the main source for working with macros and VBA. There will be a large section of videos on both of these later, so I won't go into detail on it now.